Millions of spiders have created cobwebs covering a regional Victorian town after flooding drove them out of a nearby forest. Joining me live now is Wellington Shire councillor and spider watcher, avid spider watcher, Carolyn Crossley. Caroline, can you... You're having a big laugh there. I tell you what, I wouldn't be laughing if I was close to that. Can you tell us... tell me about the phenomenon. What is going on?
Well, because of the recent floods and the big weather event that came through Gippsland, the spiders literally parachuted out of the ground. The area behind me is not normally a lake. That's usually paddocks, so the ground release for spiders, they had to go somewhere. So they, en masse, as you say, millions of them spun their webs and flew up in this amazing, probably once-in-a-lifetime experience of seeing this billowing silken parachute that they had created that all came into one. Just cover the landscape. It's just an amazing experience.
Okay, well, for those who don't know, we'll try and bring these pictures up to show our viewers exactly what's going on. But so that was behind you, and has it all gone now?
Yes, because it's spider web silk, and it's very, they call it ballooning. So it's literally a balloon that they put up to sail in the wind to get out of the floodwaters, and so it did. Yes, all of these trees behind me were all covered. This whole bank was literally covered with this silken, like a single mass of silken spider parachutes across the landscape. And so it's very transient. I've seen it once before, but in not to this extent. So I feel very privileged to have seen this.
They're not harmless. They're harmless, are they?
They are harmless. They're actually tiny little spiders.
So where'd they go?
Well, they've gone into the ground, presumably. That's where they live. So they haven't sailed away. They'll be foraging in behind me here, I'm sure. So,
okay.
You know.
And so when do you... So you said it's only happened once before, so it's not this annual event.
No, it's when there's a flood. It happens, if there's spiders around and there's the ground dwelling, they've got to go somewhere. So they go into the air, basically, and settle all on the trees just to escape. So it's very much reliant on the experiences is when there's a flood. So, we have a couple of big floods here, and that's when you see them. But this, I just happened to be there just at the peak moment to see it at its best.
Okay. Caroline Crossley, I've had enough of looking at those spiders. No, I've not had enough of you, though. You've been a delight to talk to. Caroline
thank
Crossley,
you.
Appreciate that, and we will be coming to you when we see that event again. Caroline, thank you.